Blackstone presents Sons of War 4, Soldiers, by Nicholas Sansbury Smith and Tom Abrahams. This book is read by Ray Porter. For Courtney, my soldier, my sinner, and my saint. Tom.
The end is within our grasp. We need only reach out and seize it.
Antonio Moretti.
We will erase the Morettis from history. Nobody will remember the name.
Dominic Salvatore. Chapter 1. Dominic Salvatore muted his comms and coughed into his arm, then popped an upper to stave off the fatigue from the radiation sickness. He and fellow saint Camilla Santiago sat in an unmarked SUV parked a block from the meet in a dark parking lot with three other cars.
"I wish you'd ease up on the pills," Camilla said.
Dom glanced at her, taking his eyes from the targeted intersection at North Frederick Street in West Olive. She meant well and cared about him, but now was not the time for a lecture.
"We can talk about it later. Let's focus on the mission."
He didn't know who had given Marks the actionable intelligence, but the mission was crystal clear. Observe only, unless any designated targets showed their faces. If Miguel or Esteban Vega arrived, the order was to take them out. But no one had seen either Vega since the violent deaths of Antonio Moretti's wife, Lucia, and Moose's brother, Ray Clark. The criminal world had gone deeper underground than usual. This was a chance to find out if they were about to resurface, and perhaps to trawl the waters and catch some big fish. Armed with military-issue XM5 gas-operated magazine-fed rifles, they had both concealment and a good vantage point. Six of the seven living saints were in position at strategic locations along West Olive Avenue in Burbank. They all had the new toys Marks had managed to find for them, a major upgrade from the saints' old M1 and M4 rifles, or the M1A SOCOM 16 and the 1911 handgun that Dom preferred. He scanned the surroundings with his handheld spotting scope. They were observing strict radio silence unless something was mission critical. 4 hours, and nothing so far.
"I could go for some coffee," Camilla said. "I remember a place not far from here, Coffee Commissary. It survived the war and stayed open. Don't ask me how, but they had a great cappuccino."
"Coffee sounds wonderful about now. Of course, nowhere near here is open. What is it, 0200?
Camilla gave a dry laugh.
"I wasn't serious. I mean, I could use some coffee, but I doubt we..."
Dom's radio chirped in his ear.
"This is ST2, Bettis said. "We have eyes on a target. Repeat, ST2, eyes on a target, over."
Rocky was the next voice in Dom's ear.
"Copy that, ST2. ST3 has a visual. White van, damage on the right side, no plates. Heavy tint on the windows, over."
Dom eyed the scope again. The van rolled into his line of sight and slowed to a stop as a dark SUV turned onto Olive and parked in front of the van. Dom keyed his mic.
"Eyes on second target. Black SUV. Be ready."
ST2 copy, standing by, over.
ST3 copy, standing by, over.
The white van flashed its headlights. The black SUV answered. A passenger door on the white van slid open and three men, armed with long guns, spilled out onto the street. As they positioned themselves on the street, weapons pointed at the asphalt in front of them, the rear door on the driver's side of the SUV swung open. A tall man in a dark suit stepped out into the street. He appeared to be unarmed.
"Who is that? Over?"
Dom asked.
"It's not Esteban,"
Callum Tooth McLeod said through the radio.
"And it's not Miguel. Maybe one of his people. Over."
"Hold your fire. Over."
"What about the other dude?"
asked Tooth.
"The one in the middle with the green tactical vest. Is that the Baja's big man in L.A., Ricardo Cuero? Over."
Tooth had done his homework.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.